Wrigley's Spearmint Gum presents The Howard Miller Show. And now here with Music on Records is Howard Miller.
Thank you very much, Ed Farron. Good morning, everyone. This is Howard Miller from Chicago. We're here in our town. We're having perfectly delightful weather, and wherever you are, I hope it's equally as nice. The weatherman says, and we were talking to him at the countrywide level rather than just specifically the Middle West, that it's going to be nice all over the United States of America this weekend, so wherever you are going to be, whatever you're planning to do, if it's on the outside, I think old man weather is going to be on your team playing for you every second of the time. So you plan to relax and enjoy yourself. I know of no more deserving people in the world than you because you've been working hard all week. Particularly, you have, haven't you, Mother? Well, we're going to play some music for you today. You're going to have an opportunity of meeting another great star of the record industry, a boy who we have high hopes for is going to become one of our number one celebrities of the world of music. You'll meet Rusty Draper a little while later. Right now, we want you to listen, however, to a great-selling record by the Four Lads, boys who appeared on this show a couple of weeks ago, and I think made an impression on you, as they always have on disc jockeys all over the nation. Four very fine boys from Canada who have certainly won the hearts of the American public. And here is their latest hit recording for Columbia called Moments to Remember.
January to December, we'll have moments to remember.
The New Year's Eve, we did the town. The day we tore the goalpost down. We will have these moments to remember. The quiet walks, the noisy fun, the ballroom prize we almost won.
Excuse me for being just a little bit commercial about it all, but I think that's just as delicious and refreshing and as wholesome as Wrigley Spearmint Chewing Gum. And now that you've tried the Four Lads on Moments to Remember, I hope that you'll try our sponsor's product sometime today or over the weekend. Wrigley Spearmint Chewing Gum, you're going to like it. Now, the other day, we had word that Rusty Draper was going to be traveling through the Middle West, so we called him long distance, and with our little old tape recorder, we got these sounds from the coming star of Mercury Records. Rusty, first off, let me ask you this. Where were you born and raised? Is the Middle West your home country?
Well, it's my home country, Howard. You're right. I was born in Kirksville, Missouri, northern part of Missouri.
The reason I ask that is because, for the most part, the Mercury Record Company has always led you you into pastures of folk singing more than pop singing, in a sense of the word, haven't they? I mean, well, Gambler's Guitar and things like this great new one that you've got.
They've been my most successful things. You're right, Howard.
Yes. Now, how do you personally feel about this sort of thing?
Well, Howard, I like to do rhythm songs, and if they've got a beat to them, that's my type of song, I think. And,
yes.
Until this last record, that's the type of stuff I was doing.
Well, now let's digress again, then. Back there in Missouri, you were born and raised like any other little boy, I suppose, played marbles and fell in love with girls and so on and so forth, went through high school. Then what started you in the music business or as a performer career?
As a performer, I was started at Tulsa, Oklahoma, KTUL, by my uncle. I'd always wanted to be on the radio with him, Howard, and that's how it all started when I was 12 years old.
Well, were you blessed with the talent even then, or was it just because your uncle owned the radio station that you got the job?
No, he didn't own the station by any means. He was just a performer on the station.
His
name was Cy Perkins. That wasn't his real name, of course.
Oh, Cy Perkins.
That's right.
So he started you out.
That's right.
And then after performing there on local radio for a while, what gave you your big break, would you say, Rusty? Because certainly now you're at the top of the heap.
Well, I think my big break came, Howard, when I left the Middle West, went to California, and went to a place called the Rumpus Room out in San Francisco, and I stayed there for about 8.5 years. With a fellow named Hermie King, who gave me my start and coached me. And at that same time, I had a TV show there in San Francisco, and the Mercury distributors saw me there, and they called Mr. Talmadge in Chicago, and they came out to see my act, and that gave me my break. I signed a Mercury contract with them.
Yes. Well, now, you were there in this supper club as a singer or as a guitarist and singer?
As both, yes, a singer and guitarist.
Now, today, when you perform your act in the clubs and the theaters and so forth, do you always have a guitar, or do you sometimes just like to work with the band alone and sing rhythm?
Well, I like to open my show, Howard, singing without the guitar, and then through the act, I pick the guitar up and work throughout the rest of the act with the guitar.
What is your explanation, Rusty, for the great popularity that's achieved by folk music? And certainly, it is tremendously popular. Probably isn't played as much as other forms of music, but whenever it is played, people always say, gee, doggone, that's nice. Is it because it's such a basic homespun quality? How do you figure it?
I sincerely believe that is what it is, and that people down underneath realize that. And I do think that rhythm should go along with it. I don't like the too sad a song, I suppose.
You don't like the letter edged in black type of thing,
no,
where everybody dies.
No, I don't like that type, Howard. And, too well. I just like things with rhythm and a little more, I don't know what you'd say, a little more popular vein of it.
Yes. Well, now, Rusty, when Mercury started you out up there in San Francisco, your first couple of records were strictly on a hard beat rhythm kick, weren't they?
They
you weren't
were.
Doing any folk things. But actually, your first big record was Gambler's Guitar, wasn't
that
it?
That was my biggest record. I had one called No Help Wanted that ran along the same groove.
Yes, that's right. Was that just before...
That was just before Gambler's Guitar and actually started me.
I remember.
A little bit.
Well, wasn't No Help Wanted just about as big as Gambler's Guitar?
It was about, 2/3 as big as Gambler's Guitar.
Did you get a gold record for either one of them?
I didn't, Howard. I only missed it by about 200,000 on Gambler's Guitar.
It went to 800,000.
800,000.
Gee, that's a tremendous record sale. Well, you've got one now that I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if it won a couple of million, Rusty. I think it's a perfectly delightful thing to listen to. The Shifting Whispering Sands. Where did you find the material? Did you just like this sort of song to do, or did they find it for you?
Mercury found this song for me. A couple of writers down in Tennessee wrote it, and they wrote it as country music. And actually, I think it has, besides being a country song, I think it has much more pop flavor to it.
Yes, I think there is a degree of pop flavor. Certainly, when Davy Crockett first came out, people didn't think of that as being a pop song, but heaven only knows... Total Sale of That will make it one of the big records of all times, and I don't think this is too far away from the Davy Crockett idiom, do you?
No, I don't. I think you're right, Howard.
It's a beautiful story, and of course your delivery is, like it always is, Rusty, wonderful, wonderful performance. So let's give it a spin. You stay on the line now, because we'll talk about it right afterwards, but let's listen now to this great new record that Rusty Draper has made for Mercury, which I'm sure that your local disc jockeys have played for you. We'd like to play it for you now on the network called The Shifting Whispering Sands.
Listen to the angel's story of the shifting whispering sands.
Yes, it always whispers to me of the days of long ago, when the settlers and the miners fought the crafty Navajo. How the cattle roam the valley, happy people work the land. And now everything is covered by the shifting, whispering sand.
All the miner left his buckboards, went to work his claims that day.
And the burros broke their halters when they thought he'd gone to stay. How they found the ancient miner lying dead upon the sand. After months they could but wonder if he died by human hand.
So they dug his grave and laid him on his back and crossed his hands, and his secret still is hidden by the shifting, whispering sands.
This is what they whispered to me, way out on that quiet desert air. Of the people and the cattle and that miner lying there. If you want to learn the secret, wander through this quiet land, and I'm sure you'll hear the story of the shifting, whispering sands.
The shifting, whispering sands.
Well, Rusty, I want to thank you very, very much for being with us on this broadcast. Now, you're playing there at the Rustic Cabin in Ingleside, New Jersey, just out of New York, huh?
That's right, just about 14 miles across the river from New York.
Well, please say hello to all my friends in the East, and it's been a delightful pleasure for me to have you on this show today.
Thank you so very, very much, Howard.
Thanks very much, Rusty Draper.
Bye.
And take my word for it, there's just as nice and as sweet a guy as anybody can be in show business, Rusty Draper, who I feel certain deserves the finest of successes in the world of music, and I think probably he's going to have a tremendously large seller with this one we just played called Shifting Whispering Sands, a new Mercury record. By the way, this weekend might be the last opportunity that you'll have for taking the family out for a picnic junket. If you do go and you take all those good victuals that Mama puts up tomorrow night, or even tonight, will you make certain that there's one last thing that you tuck into the basket that you take with you? Wrigley Spearmint Chewing Gum, because I can assure you there's no more delicious a repast in all the world when you play the family baseball game out there in the picnic grove than to have Wrigley Spearmint with you at all times. So you do it. I know it'll double your enjoyment of the entire weekend. But remember, please, that you get the right kind. That's Wrigley Spearmint Chewing Gum. You'll love it. Everyone does. This is Howard Miller. We've got an interesting layout of shows for you next week featuring Peter Lynn Hayes and Mary Healy. So you join us Monday and every day next week, will you, for Wrigley? Until then, have a swell weekend. Goodbye for now.
You have just heard the Howard Miller Show with music on records brought to you from Chicago by Wrigley's Spearmint Gum. Be sure and join Howard Miller Monday at the same time when his guests will be Peter Lynn Hayes and Mary Healy from their home in New Rochelle, New York. This is the CBS Radio Network.